Good morning, friends. I wanted to give you a Camp Hammer Fire update. If you didn't have a chance to read my newsletter or didn't receive my newsletter that I sent out last night, as you probably heard, our Camp Hammer staff was asked to evacuate camp facilities on Tuesday night as the fire approached. We're so grateful that they're all safe and accounted for. Now, since then, we have been seeking confirmation about the impact of the fire. Here is what we know. Three different sources have told us that they heard from Cal Fire personnel who drove past the camp entrance and peered in. And these firefighters believe the damage at camp to be extensive. They said they could see two burned structures from the highway, but they couldn't get any further than the entrance because of fallen trees. We won't know any further details until somebody can get onto the property, and that's unlikely to happen anytime soon. We will let you know when we get any further news. So how can you help? People are asking. Well, our evacuated camp staff is safe, but as you can imagine, devastated. So please pray for them, and you can help in two very practical ways. This one's a biggie. If you have a vacant house or apartment that can house any of our displaced staff members, please email val@tlc.org right away. Second, they need money to replace their clothes and other belongings that were left behind in the fire. And the best way to help is to go to tlc.org/give. And in the memo section that you see there, write staff benevolence. We use this to support staff when they're in desperate need, and these staff members certainly qualify. Now, let me close with this. When I heard this, when you heard this, if you have ties to camp, I was shocked, I was saddened, I was angry, I was in denial. In other words, I was going through the stages of grief. And you probably feel that too. All these emotions crash in on us in these moments. And all those emotions are valid. They're all part of the grief process. But I want to ask you to please resist one emotion: despair. You can resist despair because, first of all, we know that the ministry of camp has not ended. It goes on today as I speak in the lives of thousands of campers and staff members who were born into the faith there and who gave their lives to Christ there and who grew up in the faith there and now live all over the world. Many of them are in full-time ministry. The Camp Hammer effect rippling across the globe every day. No fire can extinguish that. Is Camp Hammer destroyed? No. Camp Hammer lives on in the lives of people all over the planet. But most of all, you can resist despair because of the central image of our faith, the cross and the empty tomb. The cross was real. It felt terrible. It was a tragedy. But the empty tomb is real too. And that's why I want to ask you to keep going forward with hope. I know it's been a tough year, but no matter how dark it gets, I want you to remember that God promises He will ultimately transform every single cross into a resurrection. That's the arc of our faith. That's the plot line of our faith. And I believe, I know, we will experience it even in this. We're going through the crucifixion phase maybe now. But I know there's a resurrection ahead. Yes, in life we live through agonizing crucifixions, and they probably feel like they've been piling up lately. But our faith reminds us this is not the end of the story. Resurrection always follows. So don't despair. Thank you for your continued prayers. Love you. As Hebrews 10:23 says, let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for He who promised is faithful.